Autonomous weapons explained. International discussions on autonomy in weapons systems are underway. But as technology rapidly develops, legal safeguards are not in place. Developments are happening on land, at sea, and in the air. Despite the diversity and complexity of systems, it is the functionality of the weapon, rather than form, that poses the threat. Using sensors and calculations, it is a machine that determines where and when an attack should occur. A machine does not perceive the world as people do. It relies only on reductionist data. In a simple form, we have seen this in the landmine, where, if the sensor detects a certain pressure, it detonates with no concept or care for what or who triggers an explosion. New, more complex weapons might use multiple sensors analyzing heat, shape, and motion to determine if something is a target, but they cannot understand or evaluate the whole picture in human terms, and they cannot take legal or moral responsibility for their actions. Machines are tools for achieving human goals, and people must be held responsible for their use. International discussions on autonomous weapons need to address two key problems. How do we maintain human control? And can we accept machines deciding to kill people? Human control requires a user to adequately understand how a system will function in the context where it will be used. This means understanding the system itself, how it works, and setting boundaries as to where and when it will operate. Understanding how the system functions. What will trigger the system to apply force? Might it attack an ambulance when it was supposed to attack a tank? Could it attack a fishing boat instead of a frigate? Although AI can calculate solutions to complex problems, it can make it harder for the user to understand how the system works. For example, if machine learning systems can change their own parameters and programming after activation, human control and moral responsibility cannot be maintained. Without this, we can't apply the rules that are intended to protect civilians in conflict. Limiting space and time. Over a wider area and a longer period of time, the context gets more unpredictable. There might be more objects that could falsely trigger an attack, or civilians and protected buildings next to an intended target. As time passes, the circumstances will change. Programming systems to process people as targets for death or injury by a machine reduces us to mere data points. Deliberately or accidentally, it risks discriminatory profiling based on indicators of gender, age, skin color, or other factors. We become patterns without context. We become objects. While autonomy could have some advantages, there are many risks. We must not lose human accountability and human dignity. How we engage with autonomous weapons as a society will shape our relationship with technology, AI, and automated decisions for years to come. We have an opportunity to create international law that safeguards meaningful human control and counters digital dehumanization.